engagement. Yeah. So, I mean, I realize the memory, yes, it is, but the relationship between among the students and between the student and the facilitators or the staff actually is the thing that actually stayed after the trip. So sustainability wise, we are friends. We are friends, and that stays. Rather than yes, we have done this together, and that's all. Full stop. Finish. And for that, then we'll still keep in touch in a way that how do we actually help each other. Not only that I, as a coach, will help them, but also sometimes they're actually helping me as well to get to know them better, to understand some of the issues. They come and visit me when my daughter was born, and yeah. You can find on my Facebook some of the photos. Okay, so the project is about IT. So we want to expose the students to some of the IT stuff. They normally don't have opportunity to actually to work on, including laptops, simple programs like Microsoft Office, and how do they do that? And these are some of the life skills, because when they go on about to work, and tourism is one of the best, you know, way that they can actually find job with, and of course, Cambodia. So they have to speak a little bit English, and they have to know how to use some of the simple things like Office, Word, Excel, and they have to know how to maybe, in terms of digital camera, that they know how to operate and use a digital camera, take photo, and just edit the photo bit, and then how to upload online, how to use internet. So these are the few things that we have done there with the students, with the kids there. And we play with them. And my wife actually, that's not my wife, that's my friend actually. Also joined us, I mean, because I found, yes, Angkor Wat would be one of the most, I mean, attraction for most of us that we want to go and visit. And, but I realized the orphanage has more things to offer as a tourist and go on different kind of trip. And so I actually invite some of my friends as well to join, and they join us, not throughout, but a couple of days, and it's quite interesting as well. Okay, I want to talk about this picture. You can't see very clearly the form. Okay, would that be better? Yeah, if you want, you can come to the front line. This is a small picture. This, because they're orphans, and it's a very, if you just get to know them for the first day, and you talk about this topic about family, and that will not be very appropriate things to discuss, because to them, they don't have. And so on the last 2 days, we were there for 2 weeks. So on the last 2 days, some of the students, they suggest art and craft to do a drawing. And the title of the drawing is My Family. And so this girl have drawn this. Actually, many of them have drawn this. And their ideal kind of, you know, family is they have a house. As you can see here, they have a house. And in front of the house, they have some flowers, and some of them actually draw a pond or a small river, and some trees, some, you know, animals, ducks, cats, and many of them, as I noticed, I don't know whether you have noticed or not, they have a... draw someone there. And they have drawn someone there. In the deep of their hearts, they're missing their family members. So I think the students need a little bit further to, you know, talk to them regarding this. And not only them, but some of my students also cry together with them about their families and talk about all these issues. And as I reflect back, I think it was very good and meaningful lesson for our students and for our students. Because many of our students have taken our parents for granted. And some of the students actually, after that, we did feedback and reflection session, and some of the students actually shared they actually don't really talk to their parents. And so when they go home, they just go to their room and close the door, and then, you know, get online, with friends online. And so after that, then they start reflecting, yeah, I think, yeah, I'm very grateful that I have parents, and but I've been neglecting them for a while. So maybe they say, okay, the action maybe when I go back, and I could have actually speak to them more, and then you know just join them for the things that they do, and also get to know them better. And I think that's very good. That's something that you cannot just come here and then lecture on them. I mean, some of the during the parents come session, communication session, and some parents come to us, and the thing they ask is, my kids, my boy, never talk to me. Can you somehow talk to the, you know, talk to him or not? Okay, if he's not talking to you, why would he listen to me? Yeah, because I'm just a teacher. So this is something that bring them there, and then they will feel for themselves. Okay, another story. There was one girl. Before we were preparing to leave Singapore for Cambodia, so the girl asked me, Tessie, where do we stay? How many stars of hotels? I say, wow, you see many stars there. As long as you open your eyes, so many stars. I say, oh, so you got mattress or not? I say, no, unfortunately, don't have mattress. Yeah, but I'm open to the idea if you want to buy mattress for all of us. Yeah, but you can do so. So by the time the first day that she was there, she complained non-stop. This place is this, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Then after 2 days, and she never complained. She was too tired. Come back already, then just lie down and sleep. They don't want to do anything. And then later on, then after a while, then I said, hey, you still want to get your mattress? And I seen one mattress there. And then my, it's okay. Actually, we just sleep on the front, on the floor, with some mat. I can show some pictures later on. So next surprise, that was one of the pictures I've passed to the team as well. Although on the cap it says Vietnam, but it's actually this big photo was taken in Cambodia. I don't know his name, I don't know what he's doing, and this is actually one of the freshwater lake, biggest freshwater lake. Let me recall the name. Tonle Sap, yes. And it's actually about, when I check out the size of it, I was so surprised. It's actually about 7 times bigger than Singapore. Okay. And this guy, this is what he's doing. And he's smiling at me when I take the photo. And I think I showed to my students as well, and they're seeing it for themselves, and they were, some of them, they were talking about it. They were very encouraged. I mean, although they don't know this person, they didn't actually talk to him, but just by the way that he, the spirit that he's carrying through his smile, and we all can see that he has disability. And we were told by the partner is that he would, because during the one time there were so many dynamics just blown on the ground and somewhere. So unfortunately, if you actually go into the forest or somewhere and blue areas, it may just happen to you. You don't know why, but it just happened. So this is something that I learned for myself as well. Because at any time I print it out, I put it on my index. So any time that when I feel tired, I'm complaining, look at it. Yes. For the complaint. There was one story told that there was one person that who lost his shoes, so he felt very sad, and he looked very, very. But until he saw someone who without, then he said, okay. Yes. There's always some reason for us to give thanks to and for us to feel grateful for just being who we are, not being somebody we wanted to be. Okay. I have a short video. I think because of time that. You want to, maybe a quick look at some of the things maybe I could have missed. The video is about 7 minutes, but we can just stop somewhere along the way.